Hi guys, it's another beautiful day once again and welcome back to Dexter's World Channel. Today's video, we're gonna sharing with you our success in catfish farming. Actually, when we started this farm, we envisioned to have an integrated farming. And catfish breeding is one of the things that I have in mind. I don't have a background on how to go about these things. I don't even know how to breed this catfish. But because of our effort, we discovered a lot of things about catfish farming. We told you in our previous video that the breeding of this catfish can be done in a very natural way. And I have mentioned this many months back. Today we are going to harvest our first produce of this catfish. And if you are interested to know about how to breed this one, we have so many videos about this and we can provide the link below for you to follow. And we expect that we're gonna harvest plenty of this catfish now. Well, behind me are our Power Rangers. They are ready to harvest all this catfish that are here. As what I have said, this is our first harvest, and a little later, we're gonna telling you about how we did all these things. They have grown in just a period of 3 months, and I don't know if all of them are big, but I have spotted that some of them are really big. And a little later today, we're gonna be inviting some of our friends. I would like to let them taste the recipes, different types of recipes about this catfish. I have in mind is the kari-kari catfish, catfish adobo, and maybe fried catfish. So my boys are now ready. Are you ready?
Yes.
Yeah, they're ready. And this is very easy to do, unlike the harvest of this goldfish and this Japanese koi, because we can just, you know, harvest them carefree because they are hardy. They will not die easily, unlike the Japanese koi and the goldfish. We have actually structured the water as early as 2 a.m. of today. And you will see that only 10% of the water are there. So this is gonna be an exciting thing for us, and please witness this, guys.
Hi guys, I'm very excited.
This one, it's catfish.
So guys, you will see that we have laid a net right here, a big net. And the procedure is we are going to drain all the water, and we expect that all these catfish will group here. And then that's the time that we're gonna lift this and maybe we can have a good catch. This is the catch basin and I hope this will work. This is really my first time and I don't have the idea whether this catfish during the harvest will go deep inside the mud. I don't know really, but I believe that this is more easier compared to harvesting this Japanese koi and this goldfish. So we are finally done with the harvest of this catfish from the mud pond, and we are now putting them here in the concrete tanks for conditioning. Actually, they have inferior sizes, and that is why I will make some study about this, because I am planning to go on fattening. I mean, it will feed them with so much food and then flushing out the water, and then we will study if they will grow fast compared to, you know, growing them on the mud pond. And this is the reason why I made an early harvest of this, because per experience, they're gonna grow much, much faster when we are going to feed them with unlimited food. We just have to monitor the condition of the water. So we will catch some, and then we will make this as our viand today, our lunch. We have some visitors, and it's gonna be an exciting engagement with our visitors. I will let them taste the catfish and also these rabbits. So guys, you will see that these catfish have no uniform sizes. And the reason for this is that they were actually released in the mud pond by batches. And I believe that this is the latest batch that we have released. But what I have in mind is to feed them with unlimited food, and then we will observe if they're gonna respond to, you know, the feeds that we're gonna give. And we will count another 30 days for us to make a study if how far we can grow them with this kind of food that we are giving. Actually, we are giving Filmico foods for the milkfish, and this is also good for the catfish. So we are still making a study on this and how to really rapidly grow our catfish, and putting this here inside in the concrete tanks will somehow give us an idea on how to really grow this very fast. So this is just the first batch of our catfish, and we are scheduled to load another thousands of baby catfish in the mud pond. And what I have learned also about this catfish farming is that from the day old up to 10 days, we're gonna have to put them in the mud pond so that they cannot practice cannibalism. Because it's my observation that when we allow them, this catfish, from day old to 10 days old, they will really practice this cannibalism, because some of them will really grow fast and they will become shooters. And these shooters that we say are those ones that have good DNA that can grow big, and these are responsible for eating some of the fry. So how to address this is to put them immediately at 10 days old at the mud pan. And this is the lesson that I have learned. We will experience the taste of this catfish. And with me are the most important persons that we have met. They're my friends. It's Arman, Ray, and Buddy. And they're my good friends, and we're talking about business. We would like to expand this business of rabbitry, this delicacies of this catfish. And I hope that God will guide us to our success. With us, guys, because we're gonna eat our lunch together, and our viand is this rabbit adobo. We have here this curry curry catfish, and of course we have the native chicken. This is called tinibuok here.
Our gracious Lord, we are so thankful for your faithfulness and goodness in our lives. We want to thank you, Lord, for how you have been good and sustaining our life in this time of pandemic. Thank you so much, oh God, for allowing us to gather in this beautiful place. I pray that you will bless our plans and bless the works that we're doing, oh God, for your glory and honor. Thank you for this food. We bless this that will give proper nourishment for this physical bodies as well, Lord, in our fellowship in this place. Thank you, Jesus, and the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. So guys, you will see that our catfish have already settled here in these two tanks. And the reason why I placed them here, in order for us to also venture in another project, which is called the aquaponics. And we will use the ammonia that can be produced by this catfish to grow our plants. And we are thinking about the lettuce, the pechay, and even other vegetables such as this water spinach. If we will become successful about this aquaponics thing, then that's the time that we're gonna be sharing with you our techniques. I am really very positive that we can grow vegetables right here, just right here on top of this concrete tanks. And these vegetables will, of course, supply our daily needs for the farm. We need vegetables for our animals also. We have here the ostrich, we have Gino and Susie who eats a lot of vegetables. And even these parakeets that would really love to eat this water spinach. So these are all the things that we can share with you so far. I hope you will continue to like and share our videos. And if you are new to this channel, please subscribe so that you will be notified of our future videos. We're uploading videos every 3 to 5 days only here at Dexter's World.